believe we managed to pull it off. I don't even believe it.
It was and still is hard to comprehend how far into the abyss Sarajevo had fallen. It's worth remembering that only a few short years before, Sarajevo had been the centre of international attention for entirely different reasons. In 1984, Sarajevo had hosted the Winter Olympics. In fact, the catering for the Popmart crew was set up in the bullet-riddled building where Torvald Lundin and Ravel's Bolero had taken the figure skating gold medal. But that was then.
You know, the fact that we can come and put on not just a concert, but the same concert that we put on in Paris, New York and London, I think is maybe a symbol for the people of Sarajevo that things are getting back to normal.
One of the stories Bill had passed on that night in Verona had centered around a remarkable event that had taken place in Sarajevo a short time before. In amongst the incoming artillery and sniper fire, the citizens decided, with an audacity that is still staggering, to hold a beauty contest. In the middle of a raging hurricane, they created an eye of calm and then winked it at the world. That beauty pageant would be the centerpiece of and provide the title for Bill Carter's award-winning documentary, Miss Sarajevo. Produced by Bono, the documentary is a time slice of life in the embattled city at the height of the war, rejoicing in a people's quest for normality and humanity in the most utterly inhuman of surroundings. It's a remarkable piece of work. But the muse that was Miss Sarajevo wasn't done yet. In their post-Zoo TV guise as members of the transient group Passengers, the band, Brian Eno, and the maestro Pavarotti presented to the world a truly heartbreaking love song, also called Miss Sarajevo. The song was given its first public airing at Pavarotti's War Child concert in Modena, and the video for the song again drew on the hypnotic imagery of that moment of beauty in a sea of insanity. But obviously our story doesn't end in Modena. Backstage that night in Verona, a promise had been made. The band had said they would play Sarajevo. Indeed, they had tried to organise it there and then. That hadn't happened. But the promise had not been made idly. 4 years later, the Popmart circus rolled into town.
Well, that was nice and relaxing.
Relaxing?
And we've never been greeted off by 100 troops before. I guess nothing in Sarajevo is normal.
The fact that they want to, you know, to honour a rock band is very mad to me. I mean, I would have thought it's the last thing they want. But I mean, we offered to do a benefit gig, we offered to come here, do a scratch gig. No, they wanted the whole nine yards, they wanted the 40-foot lemon, they wanted the drive-in movie, they wanted the full Popmart stage. So then we had to figure out how to get all that stuff here.
Maybe not even the band fully realized how many people were involved in fulfilling their promise. As well as the truckers and riggers and roadies, there was a veritable army made up of promoters, UN workers, politicians, policemen, ordinary Sarajevans, and even soldiers. Airports and roads were opened, checkpoints manned and guarded, barriers lifted, ceasefires established, safe passage guaranteed. Favors were called in, arms were twisted. Nobody underestimated the importance of this event happening.
I mean, just to drive through the city, and you can tell, you can't tell actually what these people have been through.
Be careful where you aim, 'cause where you aim, you just might hit.
During the war, people had to spend their nights in shelters listening to, you know, deafening rock and roll music to drown out the sounds of the shells and the mortars falling over their heads. And I guess, you know, you too was part of that noise. You know, there's a connection there. It's hard to be honest with you to figure out what's happening here. Even to talk about it can demean it.
It's a dirty day. Do you remember the songs, Bono?
Is there a time for keeping your head down? A time to turn your eyes away?
No, we can't.
Is there a time? Yeah, it's time for first communion. Time.
I hope you appreciate what you're seeing here. In the back of a car, driving through the re-emerging city of Sarajevo, flanked on either side by one half of the band that wrote a song about her exploits, sits Ivana Sirovic.
Here she comes.
Miss Sarajevo. The Miss Sarajevo. The girl who played the clown and took her crown. The girl that asked us not to let them kill her. And they're singing Miss Sarajevo, naturally.
DJ Calfiume. Travala via al mare. Che come il fiume giungerai a me. Oltre I confini esoteresitate. L'amore giungerà. The trams are beautiful, aren't they?
Yeah, definitely.
This concert's about a return to normal life. That's what they want. And they don't want a patronage, they don't want a pity. They don't want us to kiss their ass. They want us to kick their ass.
And so on September the 23rd, 1997, U2, Golden Arch, drive-in movie, 40-foot lemon and all, finally got to play Sarajevo. And by request, it wasn't a benefit gig. 45,000 screaming Sarajevans stumped up for the privilege of yelling themselves as hoarse as the vocalist. Actually, they weren't all from Sarajevo. They came from as far afield as Croatia and Serbia, Montenegro and Macedonia, Slovenia and Yugoslavia.
Good night, Sarajevo. Thank you for having us. Thank you for your generosity.
But for one night at least, they all came from Sarajevo.